My individual project is based on the armored vehicle launch bridge. These are primary, these are the vehicles which are modified from the tanks and place the floating bridge upon to that. The aim of this project is to design the working model of the armored vehicle launch bridge. The model is designed and assembled in SolidWorks using a solid modeling technique. And then I rendered these images from the SolidWorks visualize. There is a short introduction. I think these vehicles are not, these are vehicles are underrated because they are not shown publicly, but these vehicles can very well, these vehicles are very important for the troops so that they can deploy all the heavy vehicles over the trenches or rivers or any land, uneven land surfaces, so they can move easily. These vehicles can also be used for rescuing civilians in natural disaster conditions, such like floods, of broken bridges, landslides, and earthquakes in which the cracks have happened and the emergency vehicles can get from one to one. That's why. The Indian Army also has two models of these, BLT-72 and the Kartik BLT, base layering tank, it means. This technology is also used in bridge construction of bridges, in which the bridges are construction by the segments or modular parts, and they can assemble onto the site. I got the inspiration from these military tanks. This first one is the Russian military tank, and second one is the Indian BLT-72. The inspiration behind this project was that the mobility for the army or any other things, the mobility and counter mobility is very important for any army. So they can move faster, and this folding technology is also helping to designing new compact vehicles such as cranes and in the fire trucks. And any other things. The working model, in this model, there are mainly three movement parts, such as tracks and the launcher mechanism and the hatch mechanism, in which the two pilots are driving the vehicle. One pilot is driving the vehicle and second pilot is driving the bridge launcher mechanism. The bridge can be retrieved from either end. It means after that, retracting the bridge, after the all vehicles passed away, the bridge can retrieve it after that crossing the bridge, and it can fold itself and go away. These are the parts used. The first part is the hull, the main body of the tank, and the chain link, which has two, and I created the chain pattern inside the assembly so that it will be easy. And these are the two drive sprockets, which drive the tracks, and the road wheel and upper front wheels support the tracks. And these are hydraulic system, hydraulic pistons, which are used to lift the bridge. And the bridge span, which is divided into two parts, which can fold itself. This system is called scissor bridge. The hatch is the folding hatch in which the pilot sits, and the scissor launch mechanism, in which the three moving parts are there. These are the technical specifications. The scissor bridge can over 30,000 kg of. It is made of generally aluminium. which is also very rigid and can increase the mobility of the vehicle. The length, the overall length is around 9.8 meters. Oh, sir, sorry, sir. The bridge length, I mistakenly it out about 20,000 millimeter. And the vehicle can take the load up to 60 tons. The assembly of this part is taken. First of all, I selected the hull part is the main part, and I fixed this, and also and all other parts are merged with it. These are the three moments: hatch, launcher, mechanism, and tracks. So this is the assembly and rendering. I rendered this part in the SOLIDWORKS Visual Lines, and I selected the environment as Salt Lake, and the colors are added so that it feels the realistic, and I choose the best quality. These are rendered image, and these are the some references and technical specs. I taken references from the battle tank MT-55, which I follow the most, and a reference sketches that I follow to reference the all the tracks and the hull body. And thank you, sir.